finding ways to fund education. I'm Jill Horner. This is Comcast Newsmakers. With me is Pennsylvania State Representative Eddie Pashinski. Thanks for being with us.
Nice to be with you again.
You are a former teacher, so yes. You've been in the classroom, and we're talking about ways to fund education in Pennsylvania, both basic education and higher education. These have been headline items in last year's budget process and in this year's budget process. Let's talk a little bit about the challenges that you've faced in working to fund education. Talk to us a little bit about what this has meant at a local level when it comes to property taxpayers.
Well, this is a great issue to discuss. First of all, property taxes have held the burden, but the reason for that is property taxes are most stable. So the elimination totally of property taxes, I think, is impractical. And anyone that misleads the public thinking that you can eliminate them totally is misleading. It needs a combination and a balance. And we need to find all sources of income in order to provide the education, which is our constitutional requirement. Our democracy depends on an educated electorate. That's how democracy works. And if we do not provide a good, solid public education, then our entire government begins to falter. So we've had several opportunities over the last few months to try to come up with some new sources. The major disappointment is Marcellus Shale. The present law that was passed and lauded by several folks really is so inadequate. It doesn't deal with the volume. They don't charge per volume. They provide a fee that diminishes over time. We are losing anywhere between $200 and $400 million a year because of the inadequate Marcellus Shale tax that was passed. The other area is the Delaware loophole, and I think you're aware of the fact that there are some major corporations that legally find ways not to pay their taxes. And this Delaware loophole needed to be closed. This is where companies locate in Delaware with a mailbox and an office number and really do all their business in Pennsylvania and then avoid paying all the taxes. That puts a major burden on your small business and on your regular property taxpayers. That bill that was also passed out of the House, didn't get to the Senate yet, closed the Delaware loophole a little bit and opened up the Grand Canyon loophole. And what I'm referring to is they've allowed for more loopholes in that law. So that we lost another opportunity, which is worth, again, hundreds of millions of dollars. That would certainly help the situation.
And you see those as potential alternative ways to fund education.
What do you see?
What do you see, though, as the state's role in funding education as opposed to the local property taxpayers' role in funding education?
Well, right now, the governor's passing the buck to the locals. The massive cut last year of $860 million is huge. And right now, you had two school districts. One school district closed, another one's on the verge of closing. We have another four or five that are in financial disarray because of the fact that they're not getting the state dollars. That's forcing what? That's forcing larger class sizes. 14,000 education staff have been fired or furloughed. Another 1,000 on the way. Removal of all-day kindergarten, pre-K, cutting classes, charging for music and art and sports. I mean, it's forced the locals to deal with a problem that starts here in the state. And our state has the responsibility to make sure we fund at an adequate level. Now look, there's no doubt we went through a global economic collapse. But this state has the responsibility, and there are ways that we can pass dollars to the locals if we can make the tough decisions. Unfortunately, this governor has not been willing to do that. He's just willing to pass the buck.
All right, thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
We've been talking with Pennsylvania State Representative Eddie Pashinski. I'm Jill Horner.